Okay, today we're walking in the village of Oosterbeek. And this is the little village near the town of, near the city of Arnhem. And this is the first village they liberated, Oosterbeek. On September 17, 1944, 5,200 British airborne, the paratroopers, landed near Wolfhese and Hilsum. And that's way over there, on the northern side of Oosterbeek. And they landed with gliders and with all equipment, like anti-tank equipment and jeeps. They put it all in the gliders and they all landed behind Oosterbeek, at the north of Oosterbeek, including John Frost and his battalion, his second battalion. That was the name of his battalion. It was like 750 men who were in his battalion. And they went through this town, Oosterbeek, where I'm standing right now. And behind me is Hotel Hartenstein. It's a pretty known hotel because it was a headquarters of the British. I really don't have much information about that, but they turned it into a museum. So that's where I'm going. And there's a Sherman tank there, so we're gonna check that out. Okay, and we are done at the museum. It was amazing. They renovated the whole museum and it was so amazing. I really recommend you guys to visit the Museum Hartenstein, Airborne Museum in Oosterbeek. And man, yeah, props to them, really. Well, and now I'm going to sit on this couch, drink some bit, and then we're going to the John Frost Bridge. And I'll see you guys there. Okay, so I'm walking in Arnhem now, and if I look in front of me, here you can see the rail bridge of Arnhem. This was the second objective of the 1st Airborne Division, to get this rail bridge in British hands. But when John Frost and his battalion came up from there and they were near this bridge, then they saw the bridge get blown up. So the second objective was a gunner, so they went all the way that way to the main objective, and that was the Arnhem Bridge itself. So we're gonna look there now. This gun, the Vickers gun, I think it's called, is donated in memory of their fallen comrades by the 3rd Parachute Battalion to the people of Arnhem, in recognition of their courage and their unflinching support during the Battle of Arnhem in September 1944. And the gun is pointed at Arnhem Bridge. Thank you. John Frost and his men took up like 18 houses, and they were all staying in those houses over there and houses over here and maybe a little bit further back, and they hauled up these houses to get the northern side of the bridge. So you can see the bridge is there. So they had a pretty good position for a few days, and they held up very long. They hold up like 4 or 5 days, I'm not really sure. On the fourth day, I think they got captured, or that was the last fighting day, and on the fifth day they got captured. I really don't know the specific days, but it doesn't really matter. So I'm standing here next to a memorial on the bridge. Yeah, and this tells the story about Arnhem Bridge, of course, and how brave the men were of the first airborne. And you can see they have their special places. So now we're walking down the bridge to the other side to see it from the Germans' point of view. Okay, this is a little bit of a perspective of the German side. So let's talk about the Germans. There were two SS Panzer divisions who were stationed in Normandy at first, and they got struck back so hard that the whole division was like collapsing. So they were sent back to Arnhem to regroup and reorganize. They only thought there was elderly people, young children who were what the Germans usually used in their army. So they thought there were old people and young people stationed here, so that the resistance wasn't that fearsome. But they made a huge mistake, because there were two SS Panzer divisions here. I'm walking again back to the car, and it's always amazes me when I get here, just the feeling of what happened here. And you see people just going by their normal days and just going to work and everything, and that's all because of the guys who fought here. Sorry, truck passing by. But that's all because of the guys who fought here for our liberty, for the democracy we live in today. And I can't really imagine if the Germans had won, then I would be standing here now in Nazi Germany. And it's so just a weird feeling, a little bit of a mindfuck, I guess. And yeah, it just hits me so how proud I am of the guys who fought here for our liberty and for our freedom. And it's not even their own country, they're liberating other countries that they never have been or never even maybe heard of, or probably heard of, but as it still amazes me every time I visit some places, and especially when you know the history of what happened there. So yeah, this is a pretty special day again. So to close this video, when the John Frost and his 2nd Battalion were in all these buildings here, but when they were in these houses, the last hours of when they got captured, the last radio signal from the 2nd Battalion was saying, "Out of ammunition, God save the King." And that was the last thing they heard about John Frost and his 2nd Battalion before they got captured. With respect for the past and the eye on the future, this memorial remembers the resistance in Arnhem 1940-1945. Okay, I'm now at the Oosterbeek War Cemetery, and of course I can't leave this cemetery out of the video. I thought by myself, okay, screw it, I'm just going to drive here and film the cemetery. I was like 20 kilometers away, so then I thought, yeah, let's just visit it just for the video. And there are like 1680 soldiers laying here, And those are British soldiers, Polish soldiers, Dutch soldiers, and some unidentified soldiers, like 260 unidentified soldiers. So yeah, if I turn the camera around, here's the cemetery. Flowers in the wind. This plaque is dedicated to the children of this region who grace this cemetery every year, paying homage to the men who gave their lives for liberation. Arnhem Veterans Club. We Dutch people never forget the war. Never. And that just tells how deep the war is still in us and how deeply grateful we are for all those men who sacrificed their life for our liberation and our freedom. So yeah, we as Dutch people will never forget, like never forget.